Hi, I'm Vanessa Pearse. I worked for 30 years as a reluctant accountant, which I ended up doing for various reasons, including because my father died in my final year in college. And after 30 years of basically feeling I needed to do something different, I decided to try writing. And I took part in Maggie Gibson's Wild Women Writing Course in Bantry Literary Festival. And it was a very supportive group, I have to say, which gave me the confidence and the wherewithal to put words on paper. And then I really felt that my experiences in Sudan, which I worked as a volunteer accountant in my mid-20s in Sudan, and I used that as a backdrop for my book, Deniable Memories. My novel about is many different things, really. The title kind of says Deniable Memories because I'm very interested in memories, and we all have memories that other people have tried to suppress for us, or we've suppressed them for our own preservation or whatever. I found my whole experience in Sudan a huge growing up experience. And it was at times terrifying. It was military controlled. It was Muslim country, which was very, very strange for me. And it was hot, it was sticky, it was everything. I mean, the first experience I had was smuggling $10,000 into the country at the instructions of the charity I was working for. And when you're greeted with a lot of military men carrying an assortment of rifles, you find that very terrifying. Basically, Martha is the main character in the story. It's a fictional story. She comes from a dysfunctional background, and so she sees an opportunity to escape that. And so she discovers who she really is and builds up some confidence and falls in love and various things like that and overcomes various challenges. When I was younger, if I had some intense feeling, be it a positive or negative feeling, I used to kind of express it in writing. So I used to write poems or prose or anything that helped me process it. And I parked all that because I suppose, you know, with time, I kept a career going as an accountant and a mother of four children. And also, I suppose I started, you know, expressing myself in different ways, you know, talking to the family and all the rest. But realistically, I found the best way for expressing myself was to write things down. When I was in Sudan, I became very much aware of female genital mutilation being the norm for, unfortunately, for young women. And while I was there, I discovered that the nurses, the volunteer Irish nurses, were giving sterile blades to the local midwives, knowing that they would be given, being used for female genital mutilation. And obviously, I was very shocked, but it was very clear to me why they did it, and we talked about it. They were very much aware that if they didn't give them sterile blades, they would still circumcise the young girls, and that they would use whatever was available to them, including sharpened stones. And so it was a very real and horrific dilemma for the nurses. Now, interestingly enough, since then, just last year, there was a huge revolution in Sudan in 2019, which is known as the Women's Revolution. And not unlike other revolutions in Africa, it was sparked by the price of bread. And following on from that, last year, there was legislation introduced in Sudan, finally, to abolish female genital mutilation. Now, the reality, I gather, is quite different insofar as it'll take a long time for it to become a reality, because it'll have to filter down through the community activists and re-education. But there has been some success where the communities have actively pursued it. Well, towards the end of this summer, my second novel, Beneath the Image, is due to be published. And it follows Martha's story into her midlife. And she is supports a friend through domestic violence. And as well as that, she suffers a pretty appalling menopause. And it's another stage of life is launched, if you like. Holding an entire family together, you know, working with aging parents and all of that sort of thing while getting through a horrific menopause myself. I think that took superpower when I look back at it, when I was going through it.